I actually rescued Jin when she was a year old. As a puppy, she was around a month and a half when I first met her. So the people who had her had a studio, okay, where I was working. I was working very closely with them for a project. I remember when they gifted me Jin, I fell in love with her immediately. She was the most cutest puppy I had ever met in my life, and she had the most, one of those woe is me kind of sad eyes, something that she still has right now. And she was beautiful. She was just a month and a half old, away from her mom and her family, into the hands of unknown people, strangers completely, and she was shivering. And I remember that night she was crying so much. She was crying so much for her mom, and I just remember taking her very close to me, and I just wrapped her right here on my chest. I put a warm blanket and she just cuddled up and she slept. She slept all night, and that had to be repeated. That was a big mistake actually, because as a puppy, you're supposed to cage train them. You're not supposed to carry them so much and make them sleep on you, because they get used to that habit. But I really did not care, because there are things that you really need to go by the books when you're training your dog. You cannot go according to the rule book, you know, you just need to follow your instinct. And for me, she was my baby, she was my child. But as much as I loved her and as much as I wanted to take her home with me, I knew I was not able to, because I was modeling at that time and I used to travel so much, and I was staying alone in the house. And there was no way in Bombay I could find anyone who could take care of her. So I just told the people who got her for me in the studio, you know, just take care of her. But they didn't. They just didn't take care of her, because when I got back after my travels and, you know, whenever I used to go to the studio and see her, she was very frustrated. They would hardly take her for a walk. She would just dirty up their house. She would eat straight from the garbage. I'm sure they did love her in their own way, but you know, they didn't treat her really well. And I saw, you know, when I saw her ears and I saw it was cut up, it was as if someone had taken a cigarette butt and just put it on her, in her ear. I knew that she was being mistreated and I had to rescue her. And that was a time when my mom and my brother joined me in Bombay. They left Dubai and they were there. And I knew I had someone home, they were living with me, and I knew that was it, I had to rescue her. And one day I just took her out of that place, you know, without them knowing, and I just brought her home. She has been with me ever since that. She was a year old when she got rescued. I endorse the whole don't buy, just adopt process. It is so important for you to give another dog, a beautiful dog, a home, a loving home. And that's what I did with Jin, you know, because I wanted a dog always, but not having the time just made me adopt her a year later. This girl has been there through it all. My ups, my downs, my old horrible relationship to my new wonderful one. She has seen it all. She has been an integral part of my family. I remember before getting married, I told Giri, my husband, that I will not get married, or I will not travel to London if Jin is not with me. That was a condition I put forth, and he agreed. He is more obsessed with her than I am, okay? For Giri, Jin is his baby and he would give his life for her. He loves her so much. There's not a day when I speak to any of my family member, she's not part of the conversation. It's like, It goes without saying, if they would ask how's Giri or how is this one, how's that one, they would be like, how's Jin, what she's doing. She's become so important for my family, for my friends. They love her. And there's not a single person who has met her who has not fallen in love with her. She's the most gentle, loving soul you could ever meet. She's a ball of energy. She's crazy. She's a glutton, okay? But she's all heart. She is absolutely mental. And she prefers humans more than her own kind. You know, she feels like she's a human being. She understands everything. She's the most intelligent dog I've met. And I know everybody says that about their own pet, that they are the most beautiful, most cutest, most intelligent. But she is actually extremely intelligent. She knows what we are talking. She knows my feelings when I'm sad, when I'm happy. She just knows it. So that is why I thought today I would make this video, just to tell you how to take care of your Labrador. If you're thinking of you know, getting a Labrador puppy, please make sure you adopt one, because there's so many Labradors back home in India and many places, especially in India and in Dubai, that are being abandoned. And I'll tell you why. Because they are a bundle of energy till the age of 3, okay? They have a lot of energy and some people cannot deal with that and they just abandon them. Don't consider it as a pet just because you want to be cool in the social scene, okay? This is a family member. You will not abandon a family member, would you? So it is a huge responsibility. So that's my first point I need to tell you. If you're getting a dog, make sure that it is a part of your family till its last days. So if you're thinking of getting a Labrador for yourself, which I think you should, because they are the best family dog you could ever ask for, or any dogs of such, okay, because dogs are amazing, irrespective of their breed. This is my knowledge from taking care of Jin for 11 years. She's 11 years old right now. So from a pupper to an older dog, I just want to give you what I went through with my beautiful little lab, all right? She's still a baby girl for me. Labradors or Labrador Retrievers, they are very high-strung athletic dogs, okay? And they love to be of good use. And at an early stage itself, you can train them to be the best dog ever. I think an integral part of making them a very good companion goes with training. That's all I have to tell you right now to sum this one up. Make sure that we are training them at a very young age. You know, you can take them to the training center, you can potty train them. That is very, very important to do that while they are a puppy, to potty train them. For me, it was very difficult to train her, because when I got her completely to myself when she was about a year old, it was very hard for me to train her at that process. That's why she doesn't know that many commands, though she understands what I'm saying. But the basic commands like yes, no, sit, lie down, don't eat that, you know, stay there, all that she understands very well. Shake hands. At the age of one itself, she knew all of that. And this breed in general is also extremely popular, especially in the US and UK, because they are considered to be that ideal family dog because of how loving they are, how attentive they are. Like I said, they're very eager to please. And if trained really well, they can be one of the best companions you could ever ask for. Breed in general requires a lot of exercise, okay? Because that's what makes them mentally and physically stable. If they do not get that regular walk or the exercise or the attention, they tend to get into a depression state, which is not very good for them. And they also have a tendency to become obese. As a puppy, you don't need to really exercise them too much, because too much of exercise is also not good. I would say keep it after 3 months, and even after 3 months, till about they turn a year old, just make sure that their exercise is around 15 minutes a day. That to divide that 15 minutes, I mean, you can do a little bit in the morning, a little bit in the evening. Don't make them fat, because that's going to add that pressure to their bones, especially to their hip area, and it's going to get worse. You can take them for hydrotherapy. Jin doesn't like the water as much, but you know, she does like the treadmill that is filled with water, and she just walks on that treadmill. About the age of 9, I cannot recommend water therapy for dogs. It really relieves them out of that pain that they carry in their back joint. They can get really heavy. They have a tendency to put on weight, and they can eat and eat and eat. So the most important thing that you really need to remember is their nutrition. Ask your vet what is the best diet for your puppy. It can be, you know, raw food, and especially raw food. I'm talking about raw meat or whatever it is, raw vegetables and meat mixed together. If you're thinking of starting them on a raw food diet, make sure that you start that at a very early stage. To be honest, till she was around 4 or 5 years of age, there was a lot of home cooking meal that was done for this one. I tried to reduce her store-bought food, like dry food, because Pedigree was not one of my favorite brands, to be honest, since it had a lot of salt content. I refrained from giving her, you know, red meat, only because they have a tendency to smell if they have a lot of bones. Not meat in general, I'm not talking about the fleshy part, but a lot of people give their dogs bones, which is not very good for them actually. It hurts their stomach. If you feel that they're obese, if you can feel their ribs, that means you're doing pretty okay. If you cannot feel the ribs, then you know that they are getting really fat, and you need to put them on a strict nutrition and also have to make them exercise a lot. If you feel their bones bones or you can see the bones clearly, then there is something wrong with your dog. It is very important for you to plan their meal according to their age, their activity and the size. As you can see, Jin is a huge dog. She's actually one of, for a Labrador girl, she is pretty big, and that's the first thing people say when they see her. They're like, oh my god, you have a mini horse in the house. But she is pretty big. Labs need to be well hydrated. Make sure that there's plenty of water in their water bowl. What I do is I take, you know, 1 liter bottle and I keep it next to her water bowl. Anything more than 2 liters, if they drink, basically depending on their size, especially for Jin being a Labrador, anything more than 2 liters, that I would say is a bit of a problem, because it could be that they are diabetic or there's a kidney related problem. But anything below the 2 liter mark is pretty okay. You have to make sure that you brush their coat. You don't need to brush their coat every day because they've got really short hair, alright? You just need to brush it once a week so that you take that excess hair and dirt out of their fur. And it's also very important to brush your teeth. And that doesn't apply only for Labradors. That goes for all the dogs, because gum disease, they are also prone to gum disease, you guys. The sad thing is they can't even tell you if their gums are hurting or their teeth is hurting. So take a soft baby brush and take a doggy toothpaste, which you get it in your pet store, or you can go to the vet and ask what's the best one, and get a toothpaste that is only meant for them, not a human toothpaste, please. Fluoride is not at all good for them. And just brush their teeth once a day. It is very important for them not to get gingivitis. If they have gingivitis, it can affect and give them so many heart-related problems. So make sure that their gums are really, really good, because very bad gums and gingivitis can shorten their lives even furthermore. I give Jin a bath only once a month. The more baths you give them, you are taking their natural oils away from the coat. Their coat tends to become really dull, and because of their sensitive skin, they start getting these rashes, that irritation starts to happen to their skin. So please refrain from giving them a bath, like, you know, maybe twice a week or every week. Once a month is more than fine. Labradors are also prone to severe ear infections, so make sure you check that as well. Please do not use a Q-tip. That is extremely dangerous to your dog. Please don't do anything. If you feel that they have a ear infection, take it to the vet immediately. Every 6 months, please do a blood test for them, just to see their kidney level and their liver functions, just to see the test if they are doing okay, their sugar levels. And once a year, they have their regular booster shot. That is extremely important to keep all those virus away. Once in 6 months, I would say, please make sure that you give them a deworming tablet. Deworming is extremely important because it cleans out their system. It cleans out their stomach. Check for your dog's nails. If it's long, it needs to be clipped. You cannot clip it at home. Make sure that your vet clips it. They are not supposed to have fleas in their coat, because it's also very dangerous for you, especially if you have children around. The flea can make them, you know, they can get flea fever, they can get tick fever, which can kill them. Make sure when they're sleeping, you're checking their body for any lumps or bumps, because, you know, they are also prone to cancer, you guys. Big dogs in general, like for Jin example, they have a lot of these small little fatty lumps, which is called lipoma. So there's nothing to get scared of when they have lipoma, because that's just an accumulation of fat under their skin. And also, to stimulate their brain cells, you can play so many games with them, especially for Labradors, because they are such highly strong, active dogs. They need to be mentally stimulated. They get bored very easy, so you can start playing games with them. They love hide and seek. I love playing hide and seek with Jin. You know, I'll hide somewhere in the house and I'll just call out for her, and she'll be frantically searching around and around for me. And then there's so many other toys, you know. She has a special toy where you put a little treat inside, and she needs to nudge that toy for her to get those treats outside. And there's various other toys that could just, you know, keep them busy and preoccupied for a very long time. As a puppy itself, introduce her to other dogs, take her to the dog park, or introduce her to more human beings, you know, because that makes them much more friendly. The more you travel, wherever there's a dog friendly place, take them out, let them experience everything, let them walk around, run in the beach, you know, swim in the water, just, you know, sniff each and every tree in that park. Just let them enjoy their life. Don't just confine them into the four walls of your house, you guys. If you don't have the time for them, then don't have a dog. All dogs need your love, your time, and your attention. It is very, very important. They anyway have the shortest life possible for a being that gives you only love and joy. You are their entire life. You are their universe. I mean, that love can definitely be reciprocated by you as well. So please don't abandon any dogs. And please don't support breeders, okay? Just make sure that you adopt and give a loving dog the home that it requires and just change your life. I really pray and hope to God that you've learned a thing or two about Labradors, whether it's a puppy or it's an older dog like Jin. The care is the same. Jin says bye as well. Isn't it? Isn't it? Isn't it? And I hope you enjoyed watching this video, and I shall see you very soon. Bye for now.